Hey guys, what's up? This is Manas and welcome back to my channel. So guys, we'll be continuing with our discussion on development of surfaces, and the object that I'm going to take up today is going to be a cone. So this is going to be problem number 2 on cone development, and here it is. So it goes like this, a cone with base 60 mm diameter and axis 70 mm long is resting with its base on HP. It is cut by a section plane perpendicular to the VP and inclined at 45 degrees to the HP and bisecting axis. Alright, draw the development. So the object in this case is obviously a cone, and it has dimensions in the form of 60 mm diameter base and axis 70 mm. Alright, so let's write each and everything that has been provided to us in the question. Now we have to see what the condition is, and it says that it is resting with its base on HP. So that's the condition that we need to follow. Now guys, you need to think about this, and if a cone is resting with its base on HP, okay, then obviously the true shape of the base will only be evident from the top, and hence you have to start by making the top view. That is, the construction is going to happen initially below the XY or the reference line. Fine. Now let's get the details regarding this cutting plane. Okay, so we have a cutting plane, aka AIP, that is what you call auxiliary inclined plane. Alright, so this cutting plane is inclined at 45 degrees to the horizontal plane, and it is also bisecting the axis. So the axis length has been given as 70 mm, so it is going to be 35 mm above the base, or 35 mm down below the apex. Alright, now the next thing that we've got to ensure is regarding the unfolding of this cone. Okay, so when you try to unfold the cone and lay it absolutely flat, it is going to appear as a sector of any circle. Alright, and it's going to subtend an angle right at the apex, and that angle can be calculated by using this formula, 360 multiplied by radius of base upon slant height. So radius of the base has been given as 30. Okay, half of 60 is going to be 30, that's the diameter, and we have this axis 70 mm. So with the help of Pythagoras theorem, we can actually gauge this slant height. Okay, so I've used the Pythagoras theorem for calculating this slant height over here. Alright, and when you put up all these values, you're gonna get this guy, 141.8 degrees precisely is the angle that is subtended when you flatten or unfold a cone. Alright, now let's start with the construction. We're going to begin by initially drawing an XY line, okay, below which we're going to start by drawing the top view, and here we have a point. Okay, so this is going to be the point through which we're going to draw a circle, and you know very well that this circle over here is going to have a diameter of 60 mm. Alright, so phi is a symbol for representing the diameter. Now what the next thing that we've got to do is to divide this circle into 8 equal parts. That's it. Now let's name each and every point, okay, from 1, 2, 3, 4 and so on. That's it guys. Fine. Now we're going to look at this from the front, and we're going to draw the projector lines from 1, then from 2, 8, and then from 3, 7 and so on. So they're going to intersect this XY line. Now what we're doing is we're trying to create the front view, and this is the base. All right, so base over here, we're going to have 1', we'll have 2', 8', 3', 7', and so on. Now the axis length in this particular problem has been given to us as 70 mm. Okay, 70 mm. So from this particular point, we're going to have the axis over here. Okay, that's it. And the next thing to do is to give this point some name. This is the front view of this corresponding O over here. Okay, apex O'. All right, now we're going to join this 1' with O', then 2', 8' with O', and that's it. So these are what you call the generators of this cone. All right, now we have this cutting plane with bisects this axis. So this point is the midpoint of this axis over here. Okay, so that it's going to be 35 millimeters below and 35 millimeters above. So this point is the bisecting point, and through this point we're going to make a cutting plane that is going to make an angle of 45 degrees with this horizontal over here. Okay, so that's our cutting plane, making an angle of 45 degrees with this horizontal, with this line over here, and at the same time it is passing through this intersection point, which is absolutely at the midpoint. So you can clearly see that the cutting plane is bisecting this axis over here. All right, fine. Now this cutting plane is cutting the generators at different points. So let's say at this point we have this generator O'1', only one generator is there, so hence we're going to have only one cutting point in the form of A. Now this particular line over here represents two generators, one at the front, that is O2, and other at the back, that is O8. O2 and O8. So we are going to have over here two cutting points. So one is going to be C, one is going to be T. So I've left out B. I don't know why. I missed it out. No issues. Anyway, you can take any alphabet for that matter. Okay, keep it English. Don't go for Greek alphabets. Anyway, let's move further. So we're gonna have this point also for generator O3 in front and O7 at the back. So we're going to have E and F, and this point also, if you can see clearly, this point, tiny point for O4 and O6, we have to have. So we're gonna have G dash and H dash, and then lastly this generator, the lone generator, O-5- generator, we'll have this. This is 1-. So guys, this over here is 5-. I forgot to put a dash over here, so please don't mind. Okay, fine. Now guys, if you've seen my previous video on this cone topic, then you should realize that we have to pick a generator that is absolutely parallel to XY line. So you can clearly see in the top view, this generator O1 is absolutely parallel to this XY line, and hence its corresponding front view is going to show the true length. Hence, we'll say that O-1- is representing the tube length. You can also say that this O5 is also parallel to this XY line. Okay, and hence its corresponding front view will also show its true length. It's absolutely alright to take any true length. O-1- you can also take, O-1- you can also take, O-5- for that matter. Both of them, both the lengths are going to be same. Okay. So let's start, and let's start by drawing this line over here. Randomly, we're going to take this point as capital O, and then we're going to take this as the radius O-1-, and then we're going to draw an arc over here. All right, something like this. Now, as we've already calculated this angle over here, it worked out as 141.8 or something. All right. Okay, fine. So the next thing to do is to divide this sector into 8 equal parts. So initially, what you need to do is you need to bisect this angle over here into 2 parts. Then pick both these parts individually, then make 2 parts again. So 2 turns to 4, 4 turns to 8, and that's what you get at the end. So all these points have to be numbered 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, and back to 1. Alright guys, so now let's see what next. Okay, now you can see this point, this cutting point over here. So A dash is a cutting point which lies on this true length, okay. So the next thing that you need to do is you need to put this A point over here and over here. For that, you need to take a certain amount of radius. Keep one leg of your rounder here, other leg over here. All right. Now with O as center, and this one is going to be the arc, and that's your point A. All right. Here also, we're going to take the same arc. So this is again going to be point A, the starting and finishing. All right. Fine. Now let's worry about this guy, C dash and D dash. As you can clearly see that these two cutting points rather are not lying on the true length. So what we're going to do, we'll project them on the true length. Okay, let's do this. Watch this carefully. I'll draw a line starting from this point. That's it. So this point is going to be C1 dash, D1 dash. That's it. Now you need to keep one leg of your rounder here, compass here, and other leg over here. So this is going to be your new radii. Fine. Keep it over here, put an arc over here, that's going to be your point C. Alright, and put it over here, same radii, cut an arc, that's going to be your point D. Fine, so now that we have got C and D, let's work out how can we get E and F. So E is going to be a point on O3, F is going to be a point on O7. Fine. So since E and F, both of them, these two cutting points don't lie on the true length, so let's project them onto the true length. That's it. So this is going to be E1-F1-. Now keep one leg over here, other leg at E1-F1-. So that's the radii. Now with this guy's center, you need to put an arc over. Okay, so that's going to be point E for you. Then same radii, again put an arc, and this is going to be point F for you. Alright, so almost 5 points have been worked out. And 3 more are left, G dash and H dash. Now these two guys, even they don't lie on the true length. Let's project them onto the true length. So we have this point as G1-H1-. So keep one leg over here, other leg over here at G1-H1-. So that's your new radii. And again with O as center. Now this G and H are lying on 4 and 6. So at 4 we're going to cut an arc. That's it. So that's point G for you. Again at 6 we're going to cut an arc. So that's point H for you. Fine. Okay, guys. So there is only one point left. You can clearly see that this I dash lies on the true length. Okay, guys, remember O dash 5 dash is in fact a true length. All right. So no need to project it anywhere. It already is lying on the true length itself. You need to take an arc of radii O dash I dash, and with this guy's center, you need to put an arc over here. Please watch this carefully, and that's gonna be your point I, right? And what shall we do now? Let's join all of them in proper sequence with the help of a smooth curve. So that's the development of the cone. All right. And finally, you need to darken the portion which is lying below this cutting plane in the development also. So this is the cutting plane in the development. Okay. So darken this portion. Fine. And it should look finally something like this. All right, guys. So guys, that was all from my side as far as development of cone is concerned. And if you have any doubts or queries, feel free to ask. Do write them down in the comment section below. I'll try to respond in the best possible way and as quickly as possible. And in the next lecture, I'm going to meet you with a new problem on prism development. And until then, this is Manas Patnaik signing off. Take care, have a great day, and keep drawing.